Okay, you guys, we're back. Hello, hello. The big Queens wave.
Look at your hands. They're covered in paint.
I know. I thought, why wash them? They'll just get dirty again anyway. It's been my motto.
No sense in that.
No sense in that. Okay, so we're going to be doing the last bird hut painting today. This is the final painting. We're doing this really wonderful Mandarin duck.
And Marty.
His name's Marty. And what's so neat about him is that in real life, he's all these colors. He's like the artist duck. The duck for artists. I feel like that's what he is. So we're going to...
I bet some specialty paints are going to come out on this one, aren't they?
Well, we've got the...
You say it now.
We'll see. But we're going to have the magentas. Come on down. Take a look what we've got.
Scoot on down.
If you're new to the channel, you saw us going live, be sure to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up, which is a big happy like. And if you want to chat, we encourage the chat, but you must be a subscriber to chat. So, that being said,
without further ado,
these are little 6x6 Creative Mark edge canvases. They're what we call a gallery wrap because they're very wide, can almost stand up by themselves. Here's the first two we've done today. Here's the first two paintings.
Wait, so we have to back out.
John's going to back out. Here's the paintings that we've done so far. This was the first one, and this is the second. And you'll notice that you see how we painted around the edge. This is what they're almost like their own little pieces of sculpture. And that's what's so neat about doing gallery wrap paintings. You never have to frame them. And you can just, very fast thing is you can get some wall. You can just, on something like this, you can put one of those little tiny hangers in that you just kind of nail in there. It'll hang like that. Or you can staple on a little wire across. You always, when you're doing a wire, when you're framing, always do about a third of the way up and never have the wire higher than the canvas. But it should come up on an arc like that. It shouldn't be just straight across tight. You've got to have it left loose like that. Kind of interesting. But anyway, that's how you'd frame these if you wanted to hang them on the wall. Or you can just, because they're wide, they can just set. So if you're painting on these, these are great gifts. The holidays are coming up. Need something to give somebody. I think people would really enjoy them. All right, so I have gone ahead and the canvas color is, this is just phthalo green and white. And I've already transferred our duck on here, which I think is kind of neat. Now, you can see from here that this duck has a lot of bright colors. And what we know from that is that we have to have a lot of white places because of the bright colors. So we know that this wing here is going to be pretty much white with some color on it. So we'll just paint that in. You're getting the hang of this, aren't you guys? Do you feel like you're getting the hang of this, this bird painting?
Well, yeah, you think after 6 paintings or 5 paintings.
You guys are getting the hang of it. Now, the brush is damp, but it is not...
not dripping wet.
It's not dripping wet. It's just slightly damp.
Mainly damp from me washing them.
Yeah, and from just basically from John's been washing them in between, like that. So we'll just put this like that, okay? And of course we'll do the beak, because we'll start with the beak being white. And then he's got a nice thing here on his head, which is white. It's a very nice kind of white streak on his head like that. And then he's got this tail under here, this white right in there that kind of goes out like this. That's white. That's white right there. There's a little bit of a tail right here. Let me just move this out so you can kind of see it. Okay. And then this is the other side of that wing here. And it's got...
Oh, wait. This is important.
What?
What do you call a duck that steals? A robber ducky.
Oh, we love it. We love it. Thank you, Mona. Thank you, Mona.
That's right up my alley.
We couldn't have, that's marvelous. We love that, guys. That's just absolutely great.
The underpainting is a phthalo green.
And white.
Phthalo green and white.
Uh-huh. So, again, we're just, like I say, we've got a few things that need to be white here. You don't want to get that much paint. You're avoiding globs. Yes, everybody's good with that. Trying to avoid globs. And
paint the globs off.
Yeah, it's just Gloves are not.
Gloves are not your friend this early in the step.
Yeah, in this early here. Okay, so that's kind of, and I think I'm going to just do a little bit of this yellow and light orange color here for the legs. We'll see if we can get that on there like that. This little foot is looking away from us. So it's almost squared off on the bottom. And this guy's kind of sideways here. That's where that little leg goes. Just interesting. You don't really see much of the toes because they're, you know, he's facing away from us. And
the nerve of him.
Well, I know. Just it's amazing, isn't it?
It really is.
You just think you've got it and you don't. Okay. And then the I'll just take a little bit of burnt sienna here and burnt umber and go ahead and paint on my cliff. He's standing on a little cliff. In the photograph, it's white, but in my painting, it's a darker cliff. He needs a little bit more of a base to stand on, I felt, than he was given. So let's just go ahead and paint that base down here too, right? Shall we? Underneath?
Might as well. You're there.
We're there, right? So we're just going to say that's what's down here, okay?
That's the rest of the rock.
That's the rest of our little rock, okay? There he is, faced on that little rock here. Here, let's make it, there we go, kind of a rock edge. We won't even make it square. We'll just kind of give it a little bit of an edge there. So that's where he is. He's down in the middle of nowhere, and which it might appear so, the way this is, I'll take a little bit of purple now. Just come under here on his foot like that.
Now, over on the auction site, we have updated the photos of those that are done, the paintings that are done. I've got the actual paintings there now.
Yep.
Gingercookauction.com. That will run through next Saturday.
This is purple right here. And this is purple right here. Let's put a little bit of zinc white with the purple. Because it will lighten it, but not so much. We're going to say here's our some purple going here like that. The rest of the tail. Okay. So now it's good to have stuff kind of, you know, mapped out. We're going to take some cad red. Come on up here to the top of his head. This is sort of a dark red right here. And that's the only place it is. And then it goes into sort of a purple color about here. This bird has so much color in it. And it's kind of neat, I think. Let's make that a little darker. This a little darker. Let's see. Let's do that. And that. There you go. Already. Wow, you're doing that's cool. And it is, isn't it? And then right here, there's some dark purple right there. So just kind of outline that part of the wing. And there. So, and then he's got, actually, I'm going to rinse all that off now so that can be drying. If you're liking these birds, I mean, I want to show you some stuff. You know, some of you, if you're new to our YouTube channel, John and I have an art school, basically online. It's at the Art Academy. And we go from very beginner, never touched a paintbrush in your life, to super advanced. Because as you guys, the more you watch, and you get better, and you need more challenges. And a little later in the show, I will show you. There's a little bit of orange up here in the top, right like that. And now I'm going to take some yellow and a little bit of burnt sienna, just mostly yellow. And we're going to do a little bit of a little bit of cad red with that. Just a tiny bit. Okay, we're going to go ahead and paint this wing in now over that white, because that's sort of set up now. There you go. There's a pretty wing. And I'm being very careful not to touch
the darkness.
The darkness or the white paint. And I'm going to come up here like that. It's a little darker down here at the base of the wing. Then what you do, now this is the key. Then wipe your brush. Got that far. Then take some white and yellow. There's some white and yellow like that. This is such a great trick. Now we're going to come on up here and do this. Then wipe your brush. See that? This is really key to know how to do this tricky stuff. Then you kind of melt the two together like blush. And then there's this, a little of this dark right here, and wipe it off. And you sort of have this gradation of sort of this orange, and then this the light yellow on his wing. And then you can take a little bit of zinc white on here, not too much, then wipe it off. Trick is never get too much. Now, if that's not going to lighten up enough, I'll try titanium. There you go, a little bit of titanium to work that into the top of this one, which is not quite as light as that other wing. There you go. And right up in here, too. That was kind of light right there.
Yes, a little bit of orange. Question, what made Ginger choose that color for the underpainting?
I've got a background in mind, and I want this underpainting to show through.
Needless to say, it will not look like the photograph.
I've got, well, the photograph is a ridiculous background. It's some sort of, it's been photoshopped in.
No, it hasn't been photoshopped in.
Well, that wasn't the real background in real
life. Yes, it is.
No, it wasn't.
Absolutely.
I don't think so. Who has
that? That was a long telephoto lens. It's going to be totally compressed like that. That is the background.
Really?
I can give you that background.
What an ugly photo. Okay. Well, what can I say?
You know, as a photographer, we don't always get to change the backgrounds.
Well, sad you. Sad for you, because that's ugly. Okay. Sad for you.
So I guess you're going to have to wait and see what you're going to do with that funny background.
Yeah. So let's get a little more orange in here and maybe a little bit more in here like that. Let's get a little.
Hey, we'd like to thank whoever made a super chat before I even noticed. Thank you very much. You snuck one in on me. I don't know how you guys are doing. You must be doing it before the show comes on, because I usually have it at the top there. We'd also like to thank Christy for the donation that came in through PayPal.
Yes. Thank you, Ms. Christy. Thank you very much. Thank you, Christy. Yeah, this is supposed to be white. My brush is a little dirty. That's all right. And then it's white up. Actually, it's white up here. Just going to just make this head white, because we're not. There we go. There we go. And let's just keep going here with a little white. Oh, another coat of white on the beak. Okay. And then we take a little bit of pink right here, just a drop, and then you wipe off the excess and then just tap that in. Because he's got, it's interesting, he's got that little bit of, it's almost got a little red in it too, doesn't it? He's an interesting duck. I think that they have a Chinese dish called Mandarin duck. Do you think they eat these guys? I hope not. They're very pretty. Just not don't want to bum anybody out thinking about them getting eaten. It's really cute though, huh? So let's take some let's just take some naphtha crimson and come up here. And I want this to be dark under here like this. This dark red color.
Well, it came up on the last painting, and the cad red wasn't really cad red. We verified it's golden cad red, and it's red.
It's red.
It's cadmium red.
But, you know, look how, yeah, this is just naphtha crimson, right? So that's naphtha crimson. And then.
And that's red red.
That's red red. That's your red red. And let's put a little bit there on his legs so they kind of show up right like that, right?
Because you can.
So we can do that. Yes, we are empowered to do that. I like that expression. We're empowered. So here's a little bit of, like a little bit of, orange right here. I'm going to just bring it around like that. Just kind of bring it that way. It's going to be pretty dark because it's over that green. But there you go. So we've got, let's see, take a little blue here and a little bit of white. And phthalo green really makes the most beautiful blue, doesn't it? Let's just do a little bit of darker blue here, right, like that. Okay. And I want a little bit of blue right in here, the little white in it. There we go. I want that color. Now, we can't do much here because the red's too wet. We'll just mess it up. We wouldn't want to mess it up, no.
Not now.
So, I want to just take a second while I'm letting that dry for a second. I want to show you, in our academy, we have over 500 tutorials, step-by-step tutorials. And one of our most successful ones we did some number of years ago were these two birds.
Ah, the lovebirds.
The lovebirds. And you see how they make a heart? You see how they're hard?
I see that.
And a lot of our members did that. And when I was looking for photos of birds, okay, of getting some ideas for birds that I wanted to paint, I ran across one of our students, one of her paintings, and it was in a, I was on a website, very official looking website. They had all this stuff about their teams and all this stuff, and it was in a frame for sale. And they told it was an original acrylic painting, but you could buy a lot of them. Okay. And we're happy if you want to paint one of our pictures and put it on Etsy and sell it. That's fine. You nice to get a little credit from where you got it from, but that's fine. But somebody, this company in Topeka.
No. Tulsa.
Tulsa, Oklahoma. And that's at least that's where they said their website was. They had taken her painting that she had on Etsy for sale and copied it, even with her signature still on the painting.
Yeah.
And had sold three or four of them for $30 a piece.
$27.99.
Yeah, $29.99.
$27.99.
Which is pretty insulting and pretty awful. And she sent them, we found it, let her know about it, sent her a letter. And, but I mean, it's a sad day when you have to sit there and protect your artwork and from people doing that
well,
stuff.
Well, how can you find it all? I mean,
you can't find it. So if you run across stuff like that, you know, it never hurts to let the people know. If we, you know, I know this happens to Cinnamon a lot on Amazon. People just grab her stuff and sell it on Amazon. She's probably been victimized much more than anybody I know from this stuff, which, and as her mom, that makes me really mad, right?
Makes me furious.
So I just thought that I wanted to share that with you. Now, while this is drying, keep in mind that these paintings are all going to be in our auction. And there are the two of them. The first two are in the auction, gingercookauction.com. The auction ends on Saturday, a week from today. And we even have payment plans for people who want to bid and, you know, just, and we have payment plans. You can, you know, inquire about. Here's the thing. We want to hear from you if you win the auction. We want to hear from you within 3 business days. So that would be, if it's Saturday, so we'll count Sunday. We want to hear from you by the following Wednesday about either making arrangements to pay for it or having paid for it, the painting. If we don't hear from you, then we will contact the next bidder. Just letting you know that, okay? So now...
And we're having to implement that because we have 2 individuals that have not contacted us from an April.
Gosh, what were their names? Do you remember their names?
You're telling not off the top of me.
Well, anyway, so you want to check. So I'm going into my blues now, my turquoise blues. And I'm going to start doing my backgrounds.
This is the background you have in mind.
This is Thalo. Going to put a little bit of magenta with that. Let's take a little white here. That's pretty, kind of a pretty color here. I'm going to come off on the side. Now, remember, when you're doing these multicolored backgrounds, you want some of the, there's a little zinc white, you want some of the background color to show through.
The underpainting.
Underpainting. There's a little bit of phthalo. Absolutely. Use a big brush like this and take a little bit of the magenta color and white. I like that. That's pretty. And I'll paint the top and some of this like that. Just get a little bit of white paint up here. A little bit of ultramarine blue. A little bit of phthalo blue.
The secret to this is not to overblend it.
Yeah, just a few brush strokes and stop, you know. You want to come back and add a different color, you can do that. But
let it dry first.
Let it dry first. A little yellow with that. We got a little turquoise blue color. Yeah, just kind of come along here like that. There's a little bit of blue, and I'll probably add some other colors as I go. When this dries, I'll add some others. I want something really light here. Just kind of a light phthalo. Almost a Southern Ocean blue color right next to this bird. These are my first layers of color. People say, well, how do you decide which to put with which? You want a lighter color or tone next to the wherever there's a dark spot on the bird, and a darker tone where there's a light spot on the bird. So that's kind of a hint on how you might paint these.
Might take a quick peek at the top of that and just see if there's just see if it's how you wanted it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I will come back with some more colors after this dries. There's certain colors I want to add, but I cannot add them while it's still wet.
No.
So that's just gonna have to sit there and be happy, because that's all it can do. And I hope everybody's enjoyed this bird hop. If you want a chance to win the Salvador paint kit, we're giving away one with each of our videos. There'll be three that you have a chance to enter the drawing for every time after each one. And when the show's over, we appreciate a comment on what you thought about our bird hop, and also include the word hashtag bird hop, and also. If you want to have a chance to win one of the prints, the limited edition prints that are being made of these, or you could do hashtag Salvador paints if you'd like to be entered.
Salvador kit.
Yeah, hashtag Salvador kit.
It's on the screen.
It's on the screen.
Not what the queen says, what's on the screen.
Yeah, do what's on the screen. Now, I want to mention, if you're new here, is that it's up to you. We will go ahead and do the random drawing using the special computer app, and you can see right away everybody. It collates all the people that have commented for each of these videos, and it will pick somebody out at random. But we don't contact you because we have no way. We don't know what your screen name is on YouTube, so you have to contact us at acrylicpaintingwithgingercook.com. And contact us if you're a winner, because we had three prints that we awarded that no one bothered to check and see. And you have 10 days after we announce it to claim your winnings. Okay. Good to know. Yes.
Good to know.
All right. So now time for some great details, huh? I need some. I need some white right there.
If you dry enough.
Yeah, I think so. We gotta bring his little chest out up here like that. We lost some of his chest like that. No kidding. We lost that. And here's the little beak again. Okay. And we've got a little bit of a chip on this wing, like so. Let's see that we have a little bit of white under here. They're starting to come together. I mean, it's a real bird. How cool is that? A real bird and everything. just and everything. Okay, let's take a little bit of the phthalo green color and put a little bit of a dab here like that. Let's dab a bit of that on there. And then let's take a little bit of the magenta.
We will announce the winner on a Monday, I believe it's the 20th show, Monday. Live YouTube show that we do at 5:30 on Monday Central Time.
Yep.
If that is indeed a Monday. It is.
Put some more purple back here on his tail. Start bringing that out a little bit more. And Let's do a little bit more of the Dozeny purple. This was going to be real dark right here, the Dozeny. Okay, this is an interesting bird because nature has outlined him.
You have to watch our video to find out if you're a winner.
Yeah, we don't announce it on Facebook. We have a lot of people don't even like Facebook. I know, it's shocking, isn't it? But
yes.
There are people out there.
Unbelievable.
Who really find Facebook totally offensive. And they won't, it doesn't matter how great the announcements are, they refuse to watch them. You know? Which is crazy to me. It's just crazy talk, yeah. But they don't like it. One of the reasons we have a free painting club is called Acrylic Painting with Ginger Cook, and on Facebook. And what's neat about that is that, you know, we send out newsletters for sure. Every week we send out newsletters and tell you about our Monday night shows and stuff that's going on. But a lot of times you get the inside gossip, gossip on our Facebook.
The
page.
Gossip.
You
that's
get
what,
the
that's
gossip.
What we're all about. We're all about the gossip.
Get the gossip. You get to see preview of some of the artwork that's coming up a little bit early. I want to show something about that, John. Back that up. For instance, every week we're releasing.
Oh, I'm doing that now?
Yeah, because I'm letting this sit here for a minute. So John's going to back up a minute. Let me just show you this because people think, well, this woman must just paint birds. No, we teach you how to paint everything. This is a 20 by 20 canvas, and this is a new tutorial that will be coming up later in the month. It's a Southwest Cowboy there. And again, step-by-step tutorials. This was hours long. I don't know, it's about 10, 12-hour video. Because that's how long it took me to paint it. And we give you every brushstroke. You can always fast forward if you think you understand it. But we always recommend that you watch the videos first and then tackle it step by step. And you can speed them up or slow them down using that little gear. Do you guys know that? Do you have a little gear thing? Even on YouTube.
Yeah, there's a little gear thingy.
Little gear thingy. You can speed things up.
You're almost talking like you know what you're talking about.
Well, I don't. But it sounds good, doesn't it? It sounds impressive. Yes, and yes.
It does indeed.
I don't know where my camel went. Somewhere.
You had him.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the camel. As long as he's backed up. This is what's being released.
Probably tonight.
Tonight or tomorrow. The camels.
He's up there.
When I showed this to Cinnamon, she says, oh, my gosh, it looks like three wise men and the camels. I don't know. Maybe. Kind of neat, though, right? So that's.
These are very tall camels. Do you know how hard it was to find those tall camels to paint
I'm telling you what, they keep a secret. So anyway, that's just a couple of things that are happening. All right, so I'm going to take a clean brush.
And don't forget your hair products.
Oh, yeah, you guys want... Yeah, I'm going to show you the hair products pretty quick here since you guys asked what I'm doing with my hair. And, all right, so I want the light blue color right here. Yes, like that. Some light blue color right there on his head. And I want some light blue feathers here, like that. There, see, this is dried enough where I can do that. Just got to be able to do all that stuff, yeah? And then I want some of this magenta color right here on the top, right like that. Because it's got to go over white to be really bright and pretty. Okay. And then I want to take some white with that and this sort of magenta pink color that goes on his chest. I mean, that's really true. I mean, you think I made that up. Look at that. Oh, how cool is that, right? This kind of pretty pink color. Let's make it a little bit deeper down in here. Yeah. Going on his chest. And let's put a few of that right here like that on his tail. We'll put a little drops of paint color. And let's see, what else could we do? Oh yeah, we've got to get a little bit of yellow here. Now, I've had magenta on my brush. I'm going to rinse that off. A little bit of white and magenta. And I want to just put a little, there you go. White and yellow. So that was white and yellow before, but this is the white and yellow right here. And I want a little bit of yellow right there. And I'm going to put a little bit of yellow. I'm in the yellow now, in the white. And I'm going to put a little bit of yellow right here. Okay, like that. A little bit of yellow right there. Maybe a little bit right there. A little bit more on his leg. Okay. Now, what else can we do? Oh, yeah, let's get that pretty bright orange color and just give this a pop. Let's just pop these colors right here. A little bit there. It never hurts to pop the colors now. Let's take the light orange and just doing this using very thin brush strokes. See how we kind of brighten that up. Okay. Then we'll take some yellow and put that on top of that. If it's just on the edge, just don't cover the whole brush. Just do the part of it on one side. And just don't reload it each time. And that'll even pop that up even more. Okay. Let's kind of get there. There you go. That's pretty. And I think I want some of that. I need that orange on his legs. Boy, his legs just disappeared, didn't these little feeties? Let's know what happened to them, but they're back. They're back. Okay. So now you're going, well, this is cool. So let's take a little bit of red and white, because that is another way to make pink, just red and white. It's a different kind of pink. Just natural crimson and white, different kind of way. And I want this to be a little brighter pink right here and a little bit brighter color right there on his head. And then maybe something coming down like this, right like that, a little bit brighter pink. If you had Holbein pink, that would be very nice. That the luminous rose would be a nice color if you happen to own that. There's a little bit of, I want to put a little bit of pink right here. Okay. Right there, a little bit of pink. And then I've got a little bit of orange that's going right here. Out here like this, a little bit more orange. Sometimes you have to build up colors, you know? Here's some bright red, here's some, get some cad red. Here's some, ooh, big blob of paint, no good. There you go, gotta layer all these colors on. Like that. It's coming along, yes? Do a little bit of light orange just around the eye, right like this. Okay, and then maybe here on his beak. Okay, so now what happens? Well, we've got I thought I'd wait till let the background dry a little bit, which we did. So now we're going to do the next color on the background. You see how this area right here and here, you can't distinguish the bird from the background. So you got to do something else. So we're going to take some white paint and a little bit of magenta and ultramarine blue. And that makes a beautiful purple. If you don't need a dark purple, magenta and ultramarine blue. Let's put some white in that. It's too dark. If you don't need that color, let's wipe off most of the paint, get some more, wipe it off, load the brush. If you don't need that, now look what happens when we do. We're going to put that in the background. Just kind of dry brush that around the ooh, pretty, right? And just put some of this purple, a little bit more blue with that. There we go. Let's put a little bit of this purple color here. Maybe even more magenta. Come on over on this side. Wipe it off. Now here's the trick. Because I want this side to be a little bit darker. But then I can kind of fuzz this out. And even just use my finger like that. Okay, like that. There we go. Now where else do I want a little bit of that purple? I want it a little bit around here, just a little bit more, right around here. Wipe all the extra paint. And just feather that in like you're doing chalk. You want it to all just disappear, the edges. No hard edges. And the same thing here. Let's put a little of that color wanted to balance things. Let's put a little of that color over here and bring it around on this side. And this has to be dry, you guys, when you do it. So when we're doing that, you want that to be dry when you're adding these layers of background color. Okay, so far so good, yes and yes. Maybe a little bit stronger. Okay, a little bit brighter right here, okay. There we go, and I can do them right here because the there's white there, so that would be the contrast for the white then. Now, down in this area, we might just take a little bit of mixing white. Okay, nope, we won't do that. Let's try it again. A little bit of mixing white, and then wipe it all off. And then make a little circles and stuff. Make some like kind of cloud effect, a little mist coming up here. A little mysterious. A little bit of mist, yeah? Try that again. Okay. Now, make something a little darker under here so this bird shows up right there. Okay. To see how we're starting to bring the bird out of the picture. And that's the trick. If you want your bird to show up, you've got to have the contrast. And so maybe right here, I might want some, you can have that a little bit darker than that pink. Then wipe the excess paint off. Just get in the habit of doing that. Just mist it around like that. There you go. So it just all feathers out. No hard lines anywhere. This is a hard line. These are soft lines like smoke. It should look a little bit more like smoke. And not like a hard outline. Okay. Now, I'm going to dry this in a minute and show you the,
the hair goodies.
The hair goodies. But I want to go ahead and outline the bird a little bit more here. We have to put some few more details on him. On his tail and stuff. There you go. Up there, there's that wing, right like that. You kind of curve that out. And let's see, a little bit of light on top of these foots. Okay, so what do we know for sure on this bird? Well,
we know he's colorful.
And you can get away with a lot with magenta. Just, you know, play with your colors a little bit. Let's see, but this is coming under here. There's a little bit of this dark blue here. That's ultramarine blue. And something's dark right there. Okay. So let's see, how am I going to make sure that I need something darker right here. So his beak shows up. See that? Because his beak wasn't showing up enough. There wasn't enough contrast. Contrast is the difference between lights and darks. That's what you're going when you talk about contrast, okay? But now see his beak shows up because we did that. And then maybe I'll take a little bit of the stalo green and break this spot up right up here, and that still works. So I've still got my pretty colors from the background. And this is kind of how you play with them. All right, now I want to dry this. Before I do, I said I'd show you what I'm using for my hair. The last time I went to the hairdresser and had my hair cut, she showed me this stuff called Olaplex, O-L-A-P-L-E-X, number 8. And it's some sort of moisturizing mask, and you're supposed to use this as a conditioner. But she told me instead to put a little tiny bit of it on, you know, like the size of a couple of peas on my palm and then just put it on my ends and leave it in. And this is fabulous. And I get the shine from this product called Chi, called Silk Infusion. And you use, again, like next to nothing. I put some on the palm of my hand, like a quarter, and then I kind of rub them together like this, and then I wipe a lot of it off on my legs, and then I put it on my hair, because you don't want a lot. But it does give added shine to your hair. So since you guys asked.
Just put it on, you leave it on.
Just leave it on. And usually, you can do it on wet or dry hair. I usually just wait till the end and put it on. But it's a great find. I'm going to dry this while John... John, do you have something you can share with our fine friends here, Feathers friends?
You don't have anything else to show, right?
Well, I guess I could show, if you guys are looking at bird paintings and like birds, these ducks John took a photo of when we were in Canada, and this has been one of our most popular tutorials. One of our moderators up there, Steffi Jane, she did this 30x40. It's fantastic. Again, that's an Academy tutorial, beginner, you know, and really, I just, you guys, you know, a lot of different ways to paint things. You can paint it very realistic. You can paint them more stylistic. We teach you all kinds of things, and that's one. I'm going to just go ahead and dry this.
Okay. Take this opportunity right now to thank everybody that came and hung in there for the final painting for tonight. Remember to do the comment with a hashtag of bird hop. Bird hop and Salvador kit. We will be having a drawing on Monday, September 20th. So that's like a week away. A week from this following Monday. We'll be doing a drawing for the bird hop. We'll have three drawings, one for each of the birds, and also Salvador will be doing the same thing. Thank you, and thank you. If you have not subscribed, please take a moment and press that subscribe button. Smash that little bell that we'll be notified whenever we go live, and don't forget to hit that thumbs up.
And remember that the week before Mother's Day next year, Cinnamon and I haven't told anybody yet. You guys are the first to know, right? Cinnamon has planned a retreat up where she is and where we'll both be teaching up there in Pennsylvania.
In person?
In person. And is we're only taking seating? A few students each. Just a How few many? Students each. I think it's a very small number. It's less than 10, I'm pretty sure. It's just a few students each, and you'll have the opportunity to attend both classes. We won't be teaching at the same time. And she's done a couple of these, and she's very happy with them.
What do you do with the tape? I'm so confused.
Oh, yeah, I know. Wait till you see this. This is getting good, you guys. Let's see. I want to do this. This like that. So, all right. So here's my tape.
So more details will come on that as
time goes on. For those of you who think you might want to do it, I think we've never done anything like that before. It's sort of a
unique opportunity.
Good excuse of me to go see grandkids too, but you know, and see all of you. And then after that, there's going to be a meetup we'll have a meetup for people that live in the area. Maybe maybe missed out on signing up for the tutorial because
just have a little chat session.
Be booking up fast. Okay, so here we go. Squish that down. Now, I need a completely dry brush for this. Little tiny brush. This will work.
Drier than dry.
Uh-huh. And I'm going to go ahead and take glue paint, I believe. Start up here. I've tapered this. Okay. Could be a little darker than that. I'll take a little purple with it.
I'm just so confused.
Okay. Now, just bear with me, dear friends. So I guess I'm doing that. I'll put a little of this dark color right here again. Kind of lost it. Okay, so I want to dry that right there before I take the tape off, right? Don't panic.
All right, can you give that a quick try? What is the area? Where does cinnamon live?
She lives in somewhere in Pennsylvania.
That narrows it down.
She's up in the Catskills. It's going to be up in the Catskills.
I thought that's the Catskills or New York.
Well, I guess it's a big mountain range, John. I don't know.
Blue Ridge?
I don't know. Somewhere up there.
Okay.
Somewhere
up there. Hey, details to follow. But it's in the Pennsylvania area.
Let's do that. We wanted to
East get Coast. Let's do that.
All right, now we're going to curve this like that.
Oh, I think my painting dog is being challenged.
And I'm going to take a little bit of yellow right on top of that, okay? And then I want to have a little bit of light green here. Let's put a little yellow and a little bit of light green right here on the edge of this. That wasn't quite light green, but that's all right. Let's just go over it again. All right. Okay. So far, so good. Yes. Now, what we have to do is take the black Posca pen. And we got to do some of the dark that's going to be on here. To do paint or Posca pen. This bird had a lot of dark on him. We need to get the lines in here before I do anything else. And he had a little line here like this. And came down here like that. And then this came up here. Honestly, there's more little black lines. You guys, I don't make this up. You can kind of see where this is up here like this. This is the lines on this wonderful duck are awesome. And here's his little eye here. We can maybe make that a little better. And now he's got there's the dark lines on his tail. Yes and yes. And some of this is coming down like that. And there's a few little bits there. Okay. And then, okay, you're all with me here. Everybody's right on board with this nifty thing, right?
Right on board.
Yes and yes.
I haven't left you.
I'm gonna say there's his beak, and you gotta make sure he has his little forehead here. It curves up and then goes down on the beak there like that. Okay, that's real important. And then some curved lines here for the finial of the brush. Oh, yes, and they kind of match the curve here. There's a method to our madness. Yes, yes, and yes. And now we're going to do some light yellow in here like this. This is dry now, so let's see. We have a smaller brush. Yeah. It's a little smaller brush. Sometimes you just need some tinier lines. Reshape the brush like that. That must some tinier, thinner lines. This is one of these. We just got this at Jerry's. It's a Zero Silver 1900. It's a brand new one. There you go. Let's take some white now. Out of here like that, because this is a fancy, fancy duck. Yeah. So now, and then some of these actually go down further. You can see that some of these lines come down like that. There you go. Yeah, yes and yes. So where's our, yeah, we're going to get it. Now we're getting the animal here. And we've got to come in here like that and like that. Okay, with that. Yes and yes. Now, what I want to do is take the yellow paint. And the way to do the drops That's right. The way to do the drops is to get them thin at the top and kind of like a little bulb, kind of a bulb shape. Probably should do them white first. They'll show up better if you do them white first, because remember that comment I made about yellow only.
Hey, we'd like to thank Rose for the donation that came in through the super chat with a big thank you. You're most welcome.
Thank you, Rose. Very nice. You have any questions you want answered, Rose? We're here for you.
Yeah, just for Rose.
Yeah, Rose, if you got a question, you did the super chat.
You need to move to the top of the
room.
We're
all ears. You're at the top of the list for questions. We're listening just for you. Do a little shading on one side of these little paint drops. Okay.
He's now, making a mess.
And then there's the orange again down here, and we want to bring that down over the top of the blue a little bit, then show that there's maybe some orange paint dripping this way. Here's our little orange puddle down here. Okay. And let's take a bit of this cad red here. And, you know, red's one of those colors when you do two coats, you're much more successful. It's one of those things where you can... Two or more coats of red. I don't know why it makes such a difference, but it seems to. Here's a little bit of the... When you're doing puddles, you should have like a little... On the edges that's facing you, you should always have a little bit darker outline, even if it's just a puddle of paint. I'm going to just lighten that up a bit.
What month again is the retreat being planned?
It's the week before Mother's Day next year.
Week before Mother's Day 2022.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what it is. We're just letting people know now because there's just a limited seating.
Limited seating, you want to start saving your pennies for it too.
And
Rose was just so excited to hear about the retreat.
Oh, no kidding. I think it's gonna be neat. They've done a couple in their first class operations. Cinnamon and John do a first class operation on stuff like that. Let's see, I want this a little bit blacker right here. So certain things I want kind of dark. So how fun is this, you guys? Isn't it fun? Now, John challenged me not to get out the Holbein.
Couldn't do it, could you?
But I'm telling you what, on a bird like this, this is...
I knew I'd win that bet.
You guys know, this is called luminous rose. We're not doing opera. We'll do luminous rose, right? And the thing about luminous rose, let me just show you a little trick, is you can take a stick,
like a little coffee stirring stick,
just save them from like that. You don't have to, a lot of times you don't have to put out, you need a little bit of paint. If you dump half the tube out when you try it, but if you do that, then you could just work off the tube. Okay, so how's that? It's too cool, right?
Too cool.
And now we're going to take a little bit of white in this luminous rose color, because I want it pinker. Yeah?
I knew you couldn't do it. Not knowing what you're going to do with this guy.
Well, somebody's going to buy this, and I know you want the nicest.
Artie Marty.
Someone wants this. I know that. Somebody's going to want this picture. And painting. Want it nice, right? This painting. So you see, I didn't need a lot of luminous rose, just a few drops like that. A little bit of light on the top here where the puddle is of paint. And, there we go. Somebody's having a good time painting.
He needs to go with Pat.
He needs to go with Pat, the painting dog, right? So, see, look, I still had a lot of paint. I just stuck it in there. If you haven't, that's one of the best things I've discovered, you guys, is those coffee sticks for when you just need a bit of a something.
You just need a touch.
You just need a touch of something.
Without squirting it out.
And let's just put a little bit of a...
Sharon, I'd like to thank you for the donation that came through Super Chat. Super Chat.
Super Chat.
No. See, I'm telling you, we could be singers.
I know you singing artists. That. You say that, John, and I believe you. Let's just make that a little
PGA
bit
PGA would like to know how you sign up for the PA class. You must have patience. It's not being formally announced yet. You have insider information.
Yeah, you can let John and Cinnamon know that you're interested. Tell them that you saw us on the channel.
You saw us on the
Artie Marty.
Artie Marty painting.
Yeah, you can say that. Wow, how fun is you? Don't you think he needed to be a painting bird, you guys?
With all the colors he had on him, yes.
I mean, how else could he have gotten all those colors? I mean, I ask you. I mean, really, honestly, how could he have done that? Well, he just couldn't. That's just all there is to it. His eye has to be brown, by the way. Don't barely want to see the... There, I'm going to give him a little nostril.
You let him breathe. That's nice of you.
I thought so. I thought that, you know, some of the nicer things that you know, I don't suffocate my ducks.
I appreciate that.
I know. I just want this lighter right here. It's a light blue. This is a light blue. A lot going on this duck. Okay, here's just some.
He is really making a mess.
He is. Isn't he making a wonderful mess? Isn't that just the best mess?
I see that guy becoming dinner.
I can't believe they eat these gorgeous things.
I don't think they eat those gorgeous things. They eat regular ducks. Those guys are too pretty.
Well, why do they call them Mandarin ducks then?
That's just where they're from. This Mandarin orange is what you do to make Mandarin duck. It's just regular duck. You're not going to do this little guy.
Do these ducks eat Mandarin oranges?
Well, how do you think they get all the orange color? Hello? Oh.
See, I just love you because you know all this stuff, John. You're just a fountain of information.
You know it, baby.
So that's a... Now, if you get by any chance, if you should perhaps get your droplets too big, just take a little blue paint and make them get smaller. You get your little
skinny them up a little bit.
Skinny them up, and I'm going to make this a little bit wider here so that the drop shows up.
Mandarin ducks are $259 a pair here. Not many people eat them here. I would imagine not. Where is here? I don't know where the night watch is. They eat worms and weeds.
Worms and weeds?
And they taste yucky.
I'm glad they taste yucky. I'm really glad they taste yucky because if they taste really good.
They should be painters. Look at them. They're artists.
Well, everybody needs an artist duck in their studio, don't you think?
I think so.
I mean, how else could you get along in this world without one? Again, yellow is one of those colors. If you put it on, a couple of coats, it'll be brighter. See, look at that. Even the second coat's brighter, yes?
Oh, that's Canada. $259 for a pair of them in Canada? Holy moly.
Well, that's they're very proud of those, aren't they?
Apparently so. It's not one of those birds you buy one, get one free type deal.
No. We had, Cinnamon grew up, we had a lot of ducks. We had ducks and they, She used to, we had a little island in the middle of this little pond. It's not very big, but the size of a Volkswagen. And it was all out of rock and stuff. And she'd row out and feed them in the mornings.
That's a dedicated little child.
Yeah, she'd row out in her little rowboat and feed the ducks. It was really cute.
Couldn't she just throw the food over to them?
No, so I'm in the middle of the island. And they liked them. It was really interesting because they were greedy and they would like that. They would wander around. They were very brazen little ducks. They could make this a little darker here. And they would wander around and see what's different on this. I'm looking at this going.
Not quite what you want yet?
Well, it's not that. But it's that I've got the eye up higher. I think his eye's down a little lower. Maybe it isn't. I think it's okay. Sometimes I worry about the silliest things, right?
Doesn't appear to be.
Yeah, I think I will. I think I'm okay. I think I just need a little bit more on the top of his head up here. A little bit more. Let's just darken that up there a little bit. There we go. There we go. That's it. Now, if you had a little more head.
We're apologizing for going over 50 minutes, but, you know, we're the last show.
We're the last show. So we went over 50 minutes because we cheated. Because we just.
What can we tell you?
I just lightened it up above his head so you could see it, right?
I see that you did that.
Okay.
Lights and darks and all that stuff.
So this is fun. This is our Mandarin duck bird.
Duck bird.
Duck bird. Painter bird, right?
Do you think all ducks are birds?
Well, what else would they be, John?
I'm not sure. The way you worded that, I wasn't, you know, I'm just trying to find out. I know that all birds aren't ducks, but are all ducks birds? I think it's a valid question.
Do you?
Absolutely.
Do you sit up nights worrying about this stuff? Is this why you're not sleeping?
It is.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm stressing over all the paint that... There's Marty is just dropping everywhere.
There you go, a little bit of light right there. Okay. All right, you guys. I think we've got Marty, our Marty painting
duck.
Yeah, there you go. We've got him. He's gonna be painting. So to finish, and thank you very much for all our moderators who hung in there with us tonight. Here's the first bird that we did.
And then wait, we're going to have to back out. We have three to show.
This is show and tell now, right?
Here's the first
bird we did. Here's our second bird.
Why don't you do a pyramid?
Well, I can do that.
Can you?
Like so. I'm empowered
okay,
to do
most
that.
Pyramids go the other way, but that works.
Oh, wait, and you've got to drip the...
Drip some paint down.
Drip some paint down here.
Yeah.
Over the edge.
So you haven't hit that thumbs up button yet. Now's your opportunity. Do it before it gets away from you. Don't forget to come back.
Make a comment and enter into our contest and then check back with us.
On the 20th.
On the 20th.
On the live show on the 20th.
And you still have time to Monday's show that we just did Monday for a chance to win something too. If you haven't done a comment on that, you still have time before we go to Monday's show. There we go. So here's our.
So you want to use bird hop, hashtag bird hop and hashtag Salvador kit to participate in the giveaways. Details are in the description in case you forget. Check the description.
Yeah. I like that. I feel like I love the fact that he looks like he's just sort of the paint's still wet and it's dripping. Yeah.
He's getting it all over himself.
Getting it all over himself and it's still dripping. I love it. So
he's making a mess.
It's making a mess. So those are our paintings. Thanks for hanging out. Next month, there'll be another bird hop if you guys still like them. And gingercookauction.com is the place to find. The finished painting, Cinnamon's, will be up soon. And I think her first two were up
Yeah, her first two are up.
Her first after, our first two are up, and John will
I'll get these up.
We have to dry this so we can scan it, and then it will be up. But
yeah, I have her third one. So they'll be up shortly.
And we'll see you Monday, you guys. Big art hugs. Happy art hugs. That's ha for happy ha. Art hugs. Ha ha.
Ha ha ha. We're gonna leave you with the funnies again for those that didn't see it before. One last funnies to round out the show. Night, everyone.
Bye. Did I say everything?
Yep. Think you did.
Was that okay?
I think so. 20-second spot only takes 30 minutes.
Right here. One of the features that is offered on our website for... And let's try again. Besides a certificate of authenticity on the paintings, which is really the best feature...
Yes, that alone.
I haven't done click on the thumbnail yet. I did. I said click on the thumbnail.
Okay. Another
great feature of our auction site is the robotic eviction. Start again. You'd think I drank, wouldn't you? All right. Sorry.
Here we go.
Another great feature.
You want to go from the robot again? Or
yeah.
Try to get that silly robot
now? One of the great features, one of the great features of our auction site is our robotic...
Our robotic what? Oh, yes.
Is the robot the option of? Let me try.
It's a robot. What do they call an automatic bidding system?
Okay, that's better because I can't say robot apparently and bidding at the same
robot,
time.
But let's go for the automatic bidding
system. To bid, register to bid. Okay, let me start again. All right, okay, I don't know how I can't.
So close. Almost had it.
God, they couldn't afford to have me make a movie. Be there with a
first. Oh, we could never afford this.
We could afford this. All right, the budget bid for you, and then being able to walk away and not worry that someone has outbid you. Well, that's still good, but
by a quarter. Don't worry about that. What happened to hard hugs from John and Ginger?
Let's try that again.
No hard hugs here, people. You're on your own. We had our hugs before.
Okay.
That's for a little hard hug. Just a little one. I'm not talking about the 10 one.
Okay. All right.